So let's say you have an old desktop computer, or laptop like I've got here, connected to your TV working as a home media center. Now you obviously need something to control the computer with whilst you're on your sofa or in bed, but what if you don't have a wireless mouse or keyboard? What if you only have a wired device, like this Microsoft mouse that I've got here? Can you use a wired device wirelessly? Well, yeah, you can, and in this video I'm going to show you how. But first, let's take a look at this thing in action. So I'm going to use my body as a mouse pad here, which is not super convenient. But I'm going to try and open Skype, just to show you that this is possible. There you go. That is a wired mouse acting wirelessly. There's no magic going on here, no tricks. This is all real. In fact, this laptop only has one wire going into it. That's a HDMI wire for the TV. To make our USB device wireless, we'll need to connect it to a secondary device that has Wi-Fi and is connected to the same network as the device we're trying to control. I'm using this mini laptop as my secondary device, and it will act as our wireless adapter. Our wired mouse plugs into our secondary device, which then transmits the data to our main device via Wi-Fi. We're not technically making our mouse wireless, as there are still wires, but we are transmitting the mouse's data wirelessly, which allows us to control our main device without being limited to the length of our mouse's wire. This allows us to use the mouse from anywhere as long as we're still connected to the same network over Wi-Fi. There are no wires between the mouse and the device it is controlling. In addition to mice, this will also work with keyboards, webcams, and really anything that uses a USB interface. So the software you need for this is called USB Network Gate, and I'll link to it in the description. It has a free trial, and you don't need to add a credit card to use it. It needs to be installed on both your secondary device and the main device you want to control. On the secondary device, you can click the trial button and then find the wired mouse that you want to turn wireless. Click share, and then move to your main device. Click trial again, but this time we want to click on the remote USB devices tab. Find the wired mouse, and click connect. After that, you should be able to use your wired mouse via your secondary device to control your computer wirelessly. The unfortunate truth is that a setup like this is actually really stupid, and the only time I could recommend it is if you're waiting for your real wireless mouse and keyboard to come in the post. If you like this video, consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.